When we buy lumber, we purchase it in dimensions such as 4 1/4, which equals 1 inch, 4 1/4, 1 inch. We buy 5 1/4, which equals 1 1/4 inch. 6 1/4, 8 1/4, okay, 2 inches thick. So we look at the thickness, that's the first thing. Everything is described to us in board footage now. So we need so many board feet of 4 1/4 lumber. When we work in here for our project we're doing in class, we will be buying 4 1/4 lumber, 1 inch thick lumber. Okay? So a board foot would be 12 inches, right? 12 inches by 1 inch. It's a board foot. 12 inches, 12 inch, 1 inch thick. Okay. That's a volume that we're doing at multiplying three dimensions on. Thickness times width times length. We talked about those three already. Thickness times width times length. So, what does this mean for us, for what we're doing in our class here? Well, for us to determine what it's going to cost buy the materials that we want, we have to go ahead and look at our bill of materials, which will be right here. So our plans, it lists all the different pieces to make this project, and lists all their dimensions. So how do we convert that to board feet? Well, let's look at this. Are you able to see that? Materials here, the first thing that's on the list are the largest items on here, which are the legs. So when you come into class, I'm going to first collect all the work that we've been doing in class, with the measurements and the drawing and so forth. And then we're going to start talking about the bill of materials. We're going to figure out what the total board footage is for the project. And then I'm going to get you guys to look at some different species of wood and decide which type of wood you want to use to build this project. And not all wood is the same price. So you can do this project as inexpensively as $12, making it out of the wood that I just showed you here. This is poplar. Poplar is the most inexpensive around here because it grows so quickly. It gets to a very big width. You can see this piece here. That was our hardwood. And then the rest of this is all sapless, goes out to the outside there. Or you can spend more money for it and be using cherry or walnut or some of the more higher end types of materials. But that's the number we're talking about in class. Right now, I just want to talk about how we figure out our foot footage. How many legs do you think this thing has? Two, right? We have two pieces. The width is 14.5. And to make life easier, we're going to put things in decimals. We're going to multiply these things out. So 14.5 equals 14.5. 14.5. We should be able to do that. There are already some fractions on here that are not going to be as easy to figure out. The length of this, for example, is 19.3/16. So how do we make 3/16 into a decimal? Well, we grab a calculator. And we say 3/16 is the same thing as 3/16. 3 divided by 16 equals 0.1875. So 19.1875. So we're trying to find out, again, a board foot is 1 by 12 by 12, and that gives us 144 cubic inches. That cubic inches is a volume. We want to find out what volume of wood we're going to need for this, so that we can then express it in board feet. So the volume of wood would be 2, and there's two pieces, times 1, which we don't have to do because 1 times A in itself, times 14, times 19.1875. The answer is our cubic number, 556 cubic inches. Right? So the thickness times width times length times the number of pieces that we have to have there. 556 cubic inches is still. It's not 556 board feet. Remember that one board foot is 144 cubic inches. So if we take this number and divide it by 144, we'll find out how many board feet are in this number here. That large number that we have on there, we don't need to keep that. We have that on scratch paper. We can do it out in this top part of your worksheet there. This is the number that we want. Okay. As we go through and we look at different parts of this, this was the largest. That was the largest part of this bracket. So some of the other things in here that are smaller, when you go ahead and determine the board footage for those, they might not even be one. They might be 0.5, a half of a board footage when you put them together. So we're not always looking for a number that's greater than one. We're just looking to find out what the volume of those pieces we have to make is. Okay? So how do we take this now, 3.86, and make it into a number that makes sense for what we're paying? So 3.86 board feet times the cost per board foot. So in the case of copper, we pay $1.45 per board foot for copper. So 1.45. By the way, that material here is the copper. And we take 3.86 times 1.45 equals $5.50. I don't have sense of that part. We're not going to individually price these out. We're going to add them all up at the end and figure out what the total cost is going to be. Okay? So we're going to have a total cost but that would be in an ideal world, a perfect world where we've used every piece. When we go back to the factory, we'll take our wood out and go to the radial arm saw, we cut it an inch and a half longer than we're actually going to need. We have waste on that. It's not going to work out perfectly that piece we use 100% of it. So with everything we're doing, we have waste. And we like to calculate about 20-30% extra for waste. So we'll use 25%. It's kind of right in the middle there. And anything beyond that, the district will pick up. We'll have supply. We'll buy more material than is necessary or than you have calculated here. Because we know there's going to be errors as we're going along this process here. So we want to make sure we have materials that are right and some profits. So we will multiply our total cost, we'll say $13. If we added up everything, multiply it times our 1.45, and we came up to $13. Now we have to multiply that times 1.25. Okay? So if everything is $13, we multiply it by 1.25. What's the 2.25 we'll have? That's the 25% that we're adding on to our total bill of materials, our total materials calculation, for all that extra stuff, for the stuff that the person had to throw into the bin, scrap it. Okay, so we will have an extra, and we have to account for that when we do the bill of materials. So it's going to be that, number one, we go ahead and find the volume of board footage for each one. Find the volume of the board footage for each piece. Number two, add up, and we could add that 25% to the cost for the board footage. It's not going to change our final answer. So we add up the board footages, and multiply by 1.25. Again, that step there is to make sure that we account for the scrap board that we're going to be creating with this. 1.25. Use that number to find cost. So we're going to take the number that we get here, we'll call that X. We're going to take that number to multiply X times. These are different numbers, so I think my multiplication is correct here. We'll call it Y. It's going to be Y times the cost of material per board foot. So if you're using poppers, $1.45. If you're using walnut or cherry, it's only $3.50. So each species of wood that you're using has a different price tag associated. Take that times the cost per board foot of the material. Okay. Now, down at the bottom of this, we have material, we have three different areas for this. So why is it like that? You want to mix species. So if you wanted to, for the steps that we're making here, if you wanted the steps to be a certain species, and the rails to be a certain species, and the cleat to be a certain species, and the legs to be a certain species, the sheet that we're doing here allows for three different types of boards to be in this project. So you might say, my legs are made out of oak. So what was that, 3.86? So say oak. And by the way, if you come into class, I'll show you the two different kinds that we have here, red and white. I have 3.86 times that 1.25, which I'm not going to do right now. I'll just call that 4.5. Oak is $2.50 per foot. So we take this number times this number, we find out what the cost for the legs is going to be. The main thing was that oak. And we go up, we add up all the board footages for all the parts we're going to make out of walnut. We put that number there, the board footage for all that walnut, with the 25% added on. Walnut is $3.50 per board foot. So we take our board footage for the walnut part, multiply it times the cost of that, and find out what the cost is going to be for those materials. Okay? So essentially what we're doing is we're trying to break down all parts of our project to use those volumes to determine how much, how many board feet is in that volume. Then we want to allow for extra cutoffs and so forth, 25%, and then figure out the material that we're using. Okay, we'll talk about this again when I see you in class.